we have avoided to do a stress on Zimbabwe is to be defined by these precast ideologies. Because once you try to, you know, there's no one size fit all, unfortunately. You know, if you say you are a social democrat, then you would realize, I mean, for instance, communism, at one point everyone was saying in Zimbabwe, or in Africa at least, we're saying, no, we are communists. But the thing is, do we really believe that wealth needs to be redistributed to everybody? You know, it's not possible. It's not possible. People not need to work. I can say to you, for instance, when it comes to the economy, we believe in a free economy. We believe in an economy that is controlled by market forces, for instance. But that, of course, which is capitalistic, but that doesn't mean we are purely and completely capitalists. We also believe there's need to protect certain, you know, there's a need to protect, for instance, consumers. Sometimes you need to take such a step, which of course can't be capitalistic. So there's no way we can completely be defined by just one ideological framework. But of course, I can tell you, for instance, that, you know, there are certain value, conservative value systems that we so much believe in, and this is who we are. We believe in the strong conservative values about, you know, the existence of God and the need, you know, we believe in those basic values. But of course, that's not everything which defines us. We equally believe that, you know, we need, for instance, I mean, we absolutely don't believe in redistribution of wealth whereby you say to investors you need to cede 51% of your shareholding or of what you have to local people. We don't believe in that. If you invite an investor to invest in your economy, you want to make sure that they retain everything they have. I mean, like the 100% of their shares, unless the local people are able to buy shares into that organization or company. Otherwise, it's no good to then come on and say, okay, fine, this is indigenization policy, which is informed by our capitalist, by our communist belief. So you must cede 51% of your, in the first place, you invited the shareholders to come on, the investors to come. We don't believe in that. We believe in a system that allows hard work and that rewards hard work. It's one of the things that we believe. Market forces should be respected. This is the 21st century. You can't go back and say if you haven't worked for it, but the fact that you are black, you can still have it anyway. I don't think that's what we represent.
Probably.
Equality in the distribution of wealth is obviously, to me and to us, is not done by grabbing companies that, you know, people have built to
let me say, for instance, let me give you an example. Mm-hmm. How would you have addressed the land question?
The land question. Okay. For the land question, there were agreements that were put in place after the war in 1979, which was part of the constitution we had in 1979. And then there were standards set that were expected to be addressed. One of the things government should have done from 1980 was to continue to acquire land. Acquire that land and redistribute it to the people. But government never did it. When they eventually did it in 2000, it was a political move. And that's the only problem we have. Our problem is not that land should not be redressed. The land question should not be redressed. No. Not at all. Not at all. We absolutely understand that it's an imbalance which was outstanding, which in fact made people go to war. And it had to be addressed. But the way in which you address that, that's where we have a problem. Currently, if a proper land audit were to be done in this country, you would realize that, you know, Zanu-PF cronies have far more land than anyone else. We know how many farms, for instance, Gono has. We know how many farms Mnangagwa has. You go to every province, you hear this is Mnangagwa's farm. You see, and this is what we're saying. This is not proper land redistribution. You want everybody to be able to access that land. And this is what we're saying. It has not been properly done. It was so political. You see, the land redistribution itself by 2000, it was a political land redistribution, which had very little to do with the common people, the rest of us. And this is what we're saying. This is unacceptable. You see, this is unacceptable. But the question of redistributing land itself, no, there's no two ways about it. It is needed. We needed that imbalance to be corrected, but not by killing people. Not by shooting people dead and with their blood flowing in the streets. That's not how best to do it. Mm-hmm. There was no need for the scale of violence that we witnessed during
Lent. Another story is to visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.